First of all, I would like to announce the various portfolios of the ministers that have been appointed today. Chief Minister, and the Assistant Minister, Datuk John Siki Anak Tayai, Assistant Minister for Native Laws and Custom. Datuk Haji Len Talif Saleh, Assistant Minister for Workforce Development and Training. Dr. Anwar bin Rafa'i, Assistant Minister for Science, Research and Biotechnology. Then the Minister of Finance and Economic Planning, Minister Dato' Amar Abang Haji Abdul Rahman Johari, Assistant Minister Neil, Second Minister of Finance Dato' Sri Wong Chun Pong. Minister of Resource Planning and Environment, Minister Dato' Amar Abdul Rahman Johari, Second Minister of Resource Planning and Environment, Dato' Amar Haji Awang Tengah Ali Hassan, Assistant Minister Dato' Haji Muhammad Narudin bin Haji Majais, Dato' Haji Len Talib Saleh, Assistant Minister for Environment. Minister of Culture, Arts and Culture, Minister Dato' Amar Abang Haji Abdul Rahman Johari, Assistant Minister Dato' John Siki Anak Tayai, Assistant Minister for Arts and Culture, Dato' Lee Kim Chin, Assistant Minister for Tourism. Minister of Housing and Urbanization, Dato' Amar Abang Haji Abdul Rahman Johari, Assistant Minister for Urbanization Dato' Haji Talib bin Zul Philip, Assistant Minister for Housing Dato' Haji Abdul Karim Rahman Hamzah, Deputy Chief Minister, Minister of Modernization of Agriculture and Rural Economy Dato' Amar Douglas Kunggah Embas, Assistant Minister Dato' Francis Hadin Anak Polis, Assistant Minister for Rural Economy, Interior Areas and Plantation, Dato' Haji Julahi bin Haji Narawi, Assistant Minister for Rural Economy, Coastal Areas and Fisheries, Encik Markom Musin, Assistant Minister for Agriculture. Deputy Chief Minister, Minister of Infrastructure Development and Transportation, Tan Sri Dato' Amar Dr. James Jemut Masing, Assistant Minister Dato' Haji Talib bin Zul Philip, Assistant Minister for Infrastructure Development, Dato' Lee Kim Chin, Assistant Minister for Land and Air Transportation and Safety, Encik Lee Wan Lagan, Assistant Minister for River Transportation and Safety. Tan Sri Dato' Ahmad James will be sworn in later because he is now overseas. Minister of Youth, Sports and Solidarity, Dato' Sri Michael Manyin Anak Jawong, Assistant Minister Dato' Haji Abdul Karim Rahman Hamzah, Assistant Minister for Youth and Sports, Wan Rozi bin Haji Yunus, Assistant Minister for Solidarity. Minister of Industrial and Entrepreneur Development, Trade and Investment, Dato' Amar Haji Awang Tengah Ali Hassan, Assistant Minister Dato' Haji Muhammad Narudin bin Haji Majais, Assistant Minister for Entrepreneur Development, Datuk Haji Julahi bin Haji Nalawi, Assistant Minister for Industrial Development, Investment and Promotion. Minister of Welfare, Women and Community Wellbeing, Datuk Hajah Fatimah Abdullah, Assistant Minister, Datuk Abdul Rahman, Dr. Abdul Rahman Ismail, Assistant Minister for Welfare and Community Wellbeing, Puan Hajah Sharifah Hasidah binti Syed Ahmad Ghazali, Assistant Minister for Early Childhood Education and Family Development. Ministry of Local Government, Minister Datuk Profesor Dr. Sim Kulhian, Assistant Minister Datuk Dr. Jerib Anak Susel, Assistant Minister for Public Health, Datuk Dr. Penguang Anak Manggil, Assistant Minister for Local Government. Minister of Public Utilities, Datuk Dr. Stephen Rundi Anak Uto, Assistant Minister, Datuk Roland Sagah Wein, Assistant Minister of Public Utilities Water Supply, Dr. Haji Abdul Rahman bin Junaidi, Assistant Minister for Public Utilities, Electricity and Communication. Basically, there are no changes in the lineup of cabinet for the time being. And the only ministry that has additional portfolio is Minister of Finance and Economic Planning. Okay. Number two, I want to mention here that we will pursue what has been done by the late Chief Minister. We won the election about 8 months ago. And we will continue to fulfill the promises made by the late Chief Minister and we will work as a team. And we will try our best to deliver what has been promised. And I would like to mention here that we also pursue the devolution of power. We will pursue that. We will negotiate with the federal government, particularly the Prime Minister, on the rights of Sarawak, as mentioned by the late Chief Minister. I am very fortunate because I was in the main committee in the process of negotiation of devolution of power, and therefore I will continue what has been negotiated on various subjects within the context of Malaysian agreement as well as Malaysian constitution. As long as I am the Chief Minister and leader of Sarawak, we will not allow UMNO to come in. We will work together within the spirit of Barisan Nasional, but UMNO will not be in Sarawak. And finally, all of us here will pledge to protect the right of Sarawak and to pursue what we had promised in the last election. Today, the Chief Minister has requested that the Dayak leaders discuss among themselves and present it to him. We will continue that. I will concentrate in to pursue what has been done by the Chief Minister and give me time. The time I will reshuffle the cabinet when the time comes.
But pursuing state rights, what's the status of the negotiation for the?
Well, we have achieved a certain agreement with the Prime Minister, and we are still pursuing certain matters such as the stamp duty and also for the operation of the Thomas inside.
So we still pursue the
30%? Yeah.
Still pursue the
30%? Yes, as a basis for us to negotiate. But not necessarily we may achieve the 30%, depends.
Okay. Basically, on the devolution of power, it's just a continuation of what have been achieved or what the negotiations are about. There's no change.
No, just continue.
Continue.
What has been laid down by the late CM. And as I said, I was very fortunate. I was the man behind the scene. So I will continue with that.